So, Shatter, Decepticon Lieutenant, manipulative deceiver, a brilliant tactician, and the thickest character in the movie universe so far. I love her, you love her, we all love Shatter. But just how strong is Shatter in the Transformers movie universe? In this video, I will be going over that question, and spoilers, Shatter is one of the most underrated characters out there in terms of her power. So in this video, I'm going to be going over Shatter's feats, and I'll be explaining her stats. I'm going to be looking at Shatter's physical strength, endurance, speed, firepower, intelligence, and skills/utilities. We're going to be doing this to figure out how strong Shatter is in the movies. For this video, I'm going to be taking a look at how Shatter is portrayed in the movie, extra tie-in material, and some official producer statements. Unlike Hasbro's tech specs that they use to rank their characters, I'll be using my own skill right here to determine how strong she is. A 1 is an F, basically Minicon level, and a 10 is an EX, basically Prime level. Depending on the letter I assign, the respective trait falls under one of these categories, and so does their power level. So the way this will play out is that in a scale of 1 to 10, how strong is Shatter in terms of these categories? So, yeah. Now that you know the rules, we can finally start talking about how strong Shatter truly is. Let's begin. Subject: Shatter. Cybertronian class: Tactician. As you might have deduced by the name, tacticians are very intelligent individuals. Transformers who fall into this category are some of the smartest and more tactically sound characters out there in the Metos. They have vast knowledge in a variety of different subjects, whether it be in the weapons they use, the environment around them, different fighting styles, weaknesses and strength of their opponents. These guys have brain for days. This class also boasts high combat skills. Tacticians usually try to use their enemy's strength against them in order to get the upper hand on them. They are not the type of bots who would usually rush into battle without a plan. More often than not, they will let their enemies do the first move, and are more reactive than proactive when it comes to a fight, looking for an opening they can use to overpower and disable their opponents as quickly as possible. These bots also have quick battle adaptation, meaning that they're able to adapt to any scenario. If the enemy is a long-range combatant, these bots will most likely take cover. If their enemy is someone who uses brute strength, then more likely than not, they'll employ a hit-and-run strategy to tire their opponents out and look for an opening. Basically, these bots have an answer to any kind of fighting style for the most part, and are very quick to come up with counters against their enemies. The Tactician class also boasts durable armor. While I wouldn't say they're as tough or have a ridiculous amount of endurance like the Brawler class, their armor usually protects them from plenty of things, such as the dangerous hits from the Brawlers, enemy blaster fire, or the Warrior class's variety of sharp weaponry. This class often comes equipped with anti-armor weapons, weapons which are specially designed to weaken their opponents little by little or disable them temporarily. This class is especially very strong against the Brawler class, due to their tough armor which protects them from all of those hits, and their quick battle adaptation which often allows them to use the Brawler class's strength against them in order to gain the upper hand. And of course, their anti-armor weapons are also particularly effective on a lot of the bots who are classified under the Brawler class, since more often than not, those bots have armor to protect themselves, something that the Tactician class perfectly counters. However, they're pretty weak against the Demolition class, a class whose firepower is ridiculously strong, and no matter how tactically brilliant you are, there's simply no defense against being bombarded by a thousand explosions, making the Demolition class a very tricky enemy to go up against. Overall, I think Shatter falls into the Tactician class. Not only is she extremely intelligent like she's portrayed in the B-movie, but she also has durable armor since she was shot by Beast's cannon in her engines and managed to withstand that with little to no damage. And do I even have to mention her quick battle adaptation and multiple counters to Bumblebee's fighting style? It's all of these reasons combined which lead me to believe that Shatter fits best as part of the Tactician class. So yeah, she fits the checklist pretty well. Cybertronian type: Hybrid. This type of Cybertronian can triple change and take characteristics from the different type of vehicles they scan, making their base exoskeleton be an in-between version of the two. Shatter takes the fast, nimbleness, and somewhat short stature of typical car-based Cybertronians. However, she takes a slightly larger stature characteristic of Jet Cybertronians. Wings for flight and weaponry specialized for airstrikes as part of her vehicle mode. This gives Shatter a very diverse kit to apply in many different battle scenarios. And now we're going to be looking at Shatter's parameters. We are going to start with physical strength, B-. When triggered, she was able to overpower Bumblebee with her mere fist and weaken him enough to the point where he could barely raise his plasma cannon to shoot her. She has been seen lifting Bumblebee and knocking him around with very little problem. Keep in mind that Bumblebee is basically 2/3 the size of her body, and the fact that she was lifting that with little to no problem is actually pretty impressive. When Bumblebee has Shatter in a lock, she was strong enough to send Bumblebee flying briefly with just one arm, indicating that she may have been holding back on her strength until that point. Also, while briefly, it looks like Shatter's fighting style implements some small traces of kickboxing, a fighting style that favors quick and hard hits onto the target, primarily the face. She was actually able to knock down Bumblebee with the strength of her right hook during their first encounter. Unfortunately, we don't really have that many showings of her actual physical strength. All we have is the movie for any decent showings. But from what little we've seen and the fact that Shatter seems to outrank Dropkick, it's safe to say that Shatter's strength will probably also surpass that of Dropkick's. Since if you compare Dropkick's fight with Shatter's fight, it seems that Shatter's hits actually hurt Bumblebee more than Dropkick's hits, or at least caused more damage to the Autobot when you compare the hits that she landed with those that Dropkick landed during their fight. Endurance, B. Despite being shot cleanly in the midsection of her jet mode, which might I add, the vehicle mode is usually a Transformer's most vulnerable state, at least in most continuities, and in the movies, the vehicle mode is definitely the more vulnerable of the two forms. After being shot in the engine, she was able to keep on fighting after that and showed no signs of being in pain or suffering any major damage. If anything, she was just showing signs of being frustrated at Bumblebee and his human partner for disabling Shatter's tower. That's the only kind of emotion she expressed, not pain, not damage, just irritation. And this of course also indicates that Shatter must have a very thick and resistant armor plate, since she was able to survive a hit to her engine, something that, in case you guys don't know, if an engine of a jet starts malfunctioning, it's usually game over for the jet, or they typically just explode. So the fact that neither happened is genuinely impressive. She also survived the hit of a massive cargo ship, initially at least, as she was seen trying to climb out of the water while the force of the ship and the water current was still pulling her backwards, only meeting her end once she collided with the dock and was crushed by it and the momentum of the ship combined. Strangely enough, despite some good showing so far, she still found the need to take cover and play it safe when engaging one normal human military chopper. You could write it off to her being careful and not taking any unnecessary risk, regardless of the opponent, but my guess is that she was trying to lure the helicopter away from the control panel to ensure it doesn't get damaged, since she seems to be moving away from it quickly and then disposes of the helicopter once she's away from it. That's more open for speculation than anything else. So there's also a very little note, but Shatter comes equipped with a battle mask, which offers extra protection from direct hit against the head. She was seen using one on Cybertron and briefly when triple changed on Earth. Taking into account how having a battle mask can protect you from getting your face ripped off, completely smashed, and or even in some cases have your head completely obliterated, the battle mask just serves an extra layer to protection, and it's another good representation of her just having good slash tough armor plating. Speed, A-. In her jet vehicle mode, she can reach speeds of around 731 miles per hour. In her car vehicle mode, she can reach speeds of 121 miles per hour. She also has the ability to fly without her jet mode, much like Dropkick was briefly seen doing during his final skirmish against Bumblebee. This however makes her a bit slower than what she would be were she in her jet vehicle mode. However, her speed when taking flight should not be underestimated. When it comes to physical combat, Shatter has been depicted to be a swift and nimble fighter, shown to be able to outspeed and outperform Bumblebee in this department. Also, it should go without saying, but because of her slender-ish body build, she can still be quite fast without the use of her alternate mode. In robot mode, she seems to be decently fast, nowhere near as the fast-moving dreads from Dark of the Moon, but compared to a lot of the movie Decepticons, for her robot mode, she seems to sprint faster than the average Decepticon. Firepower, B+. She's armed with a B-tool underslung artillery cannon. While she's never seen using it, at the very least we can assume that it does standard minor damage towards her enemies or chip damage, and most likely ideal against enemies that can't fly, and she likely uses it for constant hit and run attacks. She's also armed with 6 AGM-65E Maverick missiles. These missiles are often referred to as bunker busters, ideal for dealing critical damage to smaller opponents and breaking the armor of larger bots. She's armed with dual ballistic round blasters as depicted by her Studio Series toy and briefly seen in the movie respectively. This is ideal for mid-range combat and can be used in conjunction with her up-close and personal fighting style. She's also armed with 2 extra blasters which fires off consecutive rocket-like shells. Against smaller opponents, it seems to be ideal for disorientation and knockback. It was also shown to be able to quickly dispose and neutralize smaller aircraft such as helicopters. This weapon is very hard to power scale since it never had a significant showing, but if I had to guess, I would say that it's comparable in strength to Bumblebee's very own plasma cannon. Intelligence A. While not a scientist, Shatter is definitely one of the smartest and most cunning Decepticons we have seen in the live-action movies so far. She was right next to Shockwave leading the siege on Cybertron, which means that she must be a pretty high rank on the Decepticon hierarchy, and therefore qualified enough to command a smaller hunter unit to hunt down Autobots. She manipulated the humans various times to get what she wanted. This is impressive, especially for a movie Decepticon, since a lot of them are always eager to just jump into a fight, while Shatter looks for opportunity in every situation. Her very own fighting style is even tactically sound. She uses her enemy's strength against them and adapted quickly to Bumblebee's swift and deadly fighting style, to the point that she was able to overpower him quite easily. She was also smart enough to build a transmitter tower out of basically spare human primitive junk. I highly doubt that it was Dropkick the one who had the brains to build that thing. After partially witnessing the fight between Bumblebee and Dropkick, she was able to learn and adapt to Bumblebee's fighting style. She had a counter ready for anything he threw at her during their initial encounter. The main problem with that fight was that Shatter let her rage towards Bumblebee consume her after he and his human partner destroyed the transmission tower, which ultimately led her to underestimating Bumblebee and then to her death. Skill / utilities, A+. Being a triple changer gives Shatter a massive utility in combat. She can fly to achieve aerial superiority against her enemies, she can use her car mode to make distance from her enemies, or even catch them off guard by quickly shifting to her jet mode. Her weapons also give her plenty of versatility. She has long-range missiles, mid-range pistols, and close-range SMGs, and that's not even taking into account her physical techniques that she uses against her opponent. Shatter's fighting style is where she really shines. She seems to favor a more nimble and dodge-focused fighting style. Bumblebee was barely able to land a hit during the entire battle. Shatter also managed to have a counter for each of his attacks. She seems to employ a fighting style in which she uses her enemy's own strength against them, since every time Bumblebee made a move, Shatter used that window of opportunity to strike back at him. With a very tough and resistant armor plating, Shatter can really take a hit. When you mix this with her cautious approach when engaging enemies, it makes her have the ability to outlast her opponents in a fist fight, giving her an extra edge in combat. Shatter can also fly without being restricted to her jet mode. Now, this may seem like a very minor combat utility when fighting someone, but when you mix that with her long range, mid range, and close range capabilities, this gives her a ridiculous number of options when fighting anyone. Overall, Shatter's utility / skills complements the other categories ridiculously well. Tough armor mixed with high speed equals a really hard to take down opponent. Ability to fly mixed with a great versatility weapons locker equals a very deadly close range and long range fighter. Shatter might not be the strongest or most durable Transformers that I covered thus far, but her entire kit is ridiculously good in the right situation. And if she wasn't consumed by her anger and frustration with fighting Bumblebee, I'm 100% sure she would have won that fight, no problem. Our final tally of Shatter's parameters are physical strength, B-, endurance, B, speed, A-, firepower, B+, intelligence, A, skill slash utility, A+. I know I said it plenty of times, but I'll say it again. Shatter is not the strongest character out there, but overall, everything that she has is like so ridiculously solid that while she might not be able to take down someone like, let's say, Grimlock or Sentinel Prime, I can guarantee you that at the very least, she will be a great annoyance to those guys. And had Bumblebee not had the power of plot armor on his side, I'm certainly sure that she would have won that fight no problem. But what do you think? Do you agree with my stat placements for Shatter, or do you think Shatter should have higher stats, or maybe even lower ones? Do you think that Shatter should be as strong as she is, or do you think this power should not be as exaggerated? Let me know if there's any other characters you would like me to cover in the future. I will post a community poll giving you some options for the next episode in the Power Level series. Let me know if there's any other character you would like me to cover in a future video, and I will be sure to do it as soon as I can. I promise you it won't take a year for the next episode. So like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video. Take care, guys.